I am so happy to see so many cheerful faces from all over Maharashtra, I hope so. Today you have come here for knowing something, okay? At least I hope already you have experienced the peacefulness and calmness of this place. Don't you think so? Yes or no? The environment is elevating, is it not? And so, you have come for this, it looks like a difficult subject. So, I'm just telling you a story first. Very simple story which I read in my childhood. Some of you must have also read it. Story of an ugly duckling. Here, the story says like this. A duck had some few eggs. After hatching, it discovered one strange looking duckling has come out. As you can notice in the picture. The poor fellow was nicknamed as Ugly Duckling. And whenever he used to go near anybody, they will run away. They will say, "Don't come to us. We don't feel like talking to you. You look so ugly." The mother also is very hesitant to take it out. In all her social meetings or anywhere, she will tell, "You better stay in the home, otherwise people will ask me a lot of questions." And if it goes out trying to walk, it will jump or try to fly. Others will say, "What? Are you a frog? You are all the time trying to jump?" So the poor fellow was completely isolated and faced a lot of traumatic, painful situations. One day, however, it felt it is enough. I must break this. I must come out. I'm not so low. Why should everyone treat me like this? So one day it escaped from the house. Then it had a lot of adventures. I don't know whether you have read this children's book story, but it's very meaningful. It entered somebody's house and they thought it's a big turkey and it's a very good meal for them. They ran after it. Then the cats ran, dogs came. It was a lot of hurdles. Then the duckling discovered it can fly a little. So it started flying to the nearby trees and escaped from these cats and dogs. And then at last, it could manage to fly even further. One day at last, it came to a lake. It was very, very peaceful environment was there. And nobody was there. It felt happy at last. At last, I'm having some restful place. Then it suddenly saw a group of swans descending. Then one of them asked, "My son, from where you are coming?" This duckling was so afraid of people. He just shrinked and said, "Oh, I'm so ugly. I'm an ugly duckling. I have no place, no parents, nobody to go. People don't love me at all. I am completely isolated." Then they laughed at him and they said, "Ah, you are a swan, a royal swan just like us. See how majestic we fly, how majestic we swim. Come on, you are also one of us." So this duckling at last realized it is no longer a duckling, but it is a swan. That too, a majestic royal swan. So this is a story which many of us, we feel identified with that ugly duckling. Because in our childhood also, some of us, we have faced all the traumas. Even the traumas sometimes continue in the adulthood. Some tauntings, isolations, ill treatments. And then we raise our own mental picture. We are like this, we are like this, we are like this. That is what we call ugly duckling. And these are the mental blocks, or we call conditioning. See, this is how we feel. Most of us, on the top surface mind, we feel good, okay. But then, deep inside me, what we call subconscious mind, there are many things which are the result of the past traumas. There is anxiety, there is rejection, rage, and all the feeling that I am not fit for anything. I am fat, I am black, and nobody likes me, I am a loser, a resentment and guilt. You just analyze and see, some type of resentment will be there in us. A perfectly happy person or perfectly the free-minded person has overcome all these things. But we don't see such persons in everyday life. So all of us, we are having these hurdles. See how it is happening. Every thought that we think, there is a ripple. This is a mind lake, and the thoughts are called in our ancient scripts as rithis. They are turning into hidden tendencies or samskaras. A drop that is falling is any type of disturbance from outside which may cause a thought. These thoughts are the rithis, as you can see. And these rithis, ripples, are going and dashing against the bank. The bank is what we call Sakshi, or witness, or Supreme Spirit, or God. Here, you see, the bank doesn't participate in any of our action. It takes a mirror-like thing and reflects, that's all. The reflected ripple comes back, and you see a dip. That is image, we say in science. In this, we say karma phala. So the image that is coming back is our own action. Because of our thoughts, our action, it is coming back. So, these thoughts and emotions, attitudes, impulses, these are all our contents. And these are coming from what? The ahara, or the food that we take. Food is not just what we take from the mouth. Food is what we take from sight, what we see, that is also ahar. What we hear, that is also ahar. What we taste is of course ahar. What we smell, that is also ahar. What we touch is also ahar. So we are grasping ahar from all our five senses. They are the causes of small disturbances on the mind lake and will cause vritti. So these thoughts that are caused, they turn into action. The action again is turned into repeated actions. Repeated action again turns into habits. Habits turn into samskara. Samskara again turns into rebirth. See, sometimes we feel and say, somebody says, oh, you have this one, your eyesight is bad. Oh, of course it is in my genes, you know. My parents are having this, that's why. But our shastras say it is not because of your parents, but because of yourself. We only inherit what we have done in the past. We only inherit our own genes. It's a very strange thing, no? But it is true. Even the modern science is discovering that slowly and steadily. What we think, it is somebody else have done, so I am suffering like this. It is wrong. I am suffering all because of myself. So this, it is even causes rebirth. And then again it turns into samskar. And it again sprouts into thoughts. So, we'll never be free until we free ourselves from the prison of our own false thoughts. You have noticed in the ugly duckling, you are a third person, you are looking at the duckling. Ah, how foolish! Why I didn't understand this is on? But we are doing the same thing. As a third person, I can look at that, and then I can say, oh yes, it is, we can come in. But it is we are also doing the exactly same thing. Even if Swamiji comes and tells you, no, you are not this, you are Atman, you are the children of immortal bliss, we will never believe. No, no, we are like this ugly duckling. No, we are still that. So our activities create samskaras which may bypass our conscious mind. We will not even know, and it will sink deep into subconscious. So Swamiji says, it is we are making ourselves by our own thoughts. So these are the actually physical and mental blocks described by Patanjali. I will just go quickly because I don't want to give you a big dose of any classic text. So he says he is the earliest psychologist and evolutionist, so to say. Very scientifically he has described entire thing. And it is so scientific, though it is written in Sanskrit, every formula gives us a lot. If we go on meditating, we get a lot of solution. So he says about these blocks, how many obstructions do we have? Vyadhi, sickness. When we get sick, we can't do anything. And there is mental laziness. Even though I want to do, my mind will not allow me. It's okay, you take a little bit rest and then we will do. The lack of enthusiasm. These are all the blocks. Doubt is one of the biggest blocks. However much we say, no, you are Atman, you are this, you are that, we say, oh, I don't believe. So, alasya, and these are this unsteadiness in concentration, and these are some of the blocks that you are seeing. And he also gives a remedy in a very beautiful way, in a small sutras or formulas. He says, if you are feeling unhappy, or some of our mental blocks he describes as grief, despondency, trembling of the body, irregular breathing, and also so on. And then he tells us to rise opposite currents for calming the mind. So how? He says, for towards unhappy people, if they react that way, you have to show karuna. But if there is elation and the people are happy with some of the achievements, you should also delight with the virtues. But some people will be disturbing you all the time. What do you do with them? You have to rise upeksha, or you should be indifferent towards them. Udasin, we say. Then you have to be friendly towards a really happy and positive people. Our company is very, very important, you know. Sometimes you have noticed how our whole mind changes because of company. Say, if you are in a good company, you will feel like doing this or doing that. For example, today all of you have come. Some of your friends must have told you, in Chardamar there is retreat, let us go. So you are having good friends and good company, so you have come. But some others will say, oh, why should we waste time there? Instead, let us go to cinema or something else. So that time, you are another type of company, they will drag you to the negative things. So we have to be careful about the company also. So this is one of the sutras of Patanjali, Pratipaksha Bhavana. This is for the removing mental blocks. So these are the dictum given by Patanjali, that is, we have to take right ahara, the food should be all right, and rhythmic breathing and postures, and the right conduct, a regulated lifestyle and habits. See, some of us, we may feel, then there is no hope for us. We have developed this sort of mental blocks from long, long time. I don't know how to remove it. But we are always, there is hope. How? In our nature itself, you look at the iceberg picture again. This iceberg symbolizes our mind. Okay? The uppermost is conscious mind, which we all know. The inner thing is how much is inside? How much of iceberg is inside and how much is outside? You know how much? 1/9 is outside and 8/9 is inside. So subconscious we don't know. And subconscious is the root of all these disturbances, we know. But there is still hope. What is the hope? See, unconscious, what we say, the common background that connects ourselves to universal mind. So we share the universal mind. We are nothing but, just like in an ocean, just like in our meditation we said, imagine a bright, lighted ocean, the Divine Spirit, and think yourself as a small glass put inside the ocean. The mind that I have caught in this water that I have caught here is my mind. So we are all connected. We are completely connected. So what we feel that we are isolated, we are this and we are that, is all superficial thing. If we analyze a little bit, we will understand. At the back of everybody, there is that universal spirit. We all belong to that. So, here is one thing that all of us must think properly. If I hurt somebody, I'm hurting myself. If I hate someone, I'm hating myself. Whatever I give to the world, it will come back to me as boomerang. If I give hatred, the hatred will come back. If I give love, love will come back to me. See, this is a picture. It's showing a small boy standing in front of the mountain. No? You know the story. A small shepherd boy went up the mountains and stood there and shouted. He heard the echo. Hey, who are there? Then immediately the shout came. Hey, who are there? Then he thought maybe some boys mischievously hiding and shouting at him. Hey, come out! Then it came out, come out! Then he said, I hate you! Then everybody shouted, I hate you, I hate you, I hate you. The boy got afraid. I'll kill you, he said. Then immediately the sound came back. I will kill you, I will kill you, I will kill you. Then he really got afraid that time. He ran back home. Then some elder said, no, instead of saying I will kill you tell I love you. So the boy again tried to go up again and shouted, I love you. Then immediately the shouts came from every side, I love you, I love you, I love you. So this is what is happening to us actually. In the universe, we say, ah, it is like this. Then immediately it comes back to us, ah, it is like this. Oh, you are so bad. Immediately it comes back to us, you are so bad. So we have to be careful what we give to the universe. That only comes back to us and we call it as boomerang karma. That is what is called boomerang. Boomerang, you know, it is like a small weapon which is in this shape, and the tribals in everywhere, they use it. It goes and comes back like this to that giver. to the one who throws. So, whatever we give, we think it is over. I have told some bad words and I will forget. It won't happen. That will come back. A lot of stories are there, real stories, real life stories, that type of things are happening. So I will come to it once again if I get chance. So, how the thoughts are carried to next birth, even in our modern times, some of our, even the doctor brainwashers are this type of people, in the Western people, are also done a lot of research and they have told us. Now the wonderful or funny thing is, when our ancestors tell us, we don't care. But when our Western Pandits, they say, we say, oh yes, they are saying this. So this type of instances are coming like anything nowadays. Nowadays, so many books are published about the past birth and reincarnation. How the karma phala is coming back to us. The same coin, the coin that I give. Some are really terrific, of course. But some are nice to hear. So I will, when I get time, I will tell you the next day. So this is our story, it's continuing. We say, once we decide, yes, I have to come out of this home. This is what we call out-of-the-box thinking. Once you decide, no, I am going to change my life. How can I do it? And we start struggling, as Patanjali says, then we have started our out-of-the-box thinking. Of course, we have to face a lot of hurdles, as it is already shown to you. So many types of bhav, so many types of attitudes we have to face. And Patanjali gives in a very small formula how to face each of the thoughts. Say, one small instance in this I will tell you, that is from Abdul Kalam's book. I don't know how many of you have read The Wings of Fire. Yes, then hands up, how many have read? Of course, Abdul Kalam's name everybody has heard, is it not? Yes. Hope so. So he was our ex-president, he was our missile man, he was our scientist, who was admired all over the world, not only in our country. So when he was young, just then he passed in the Indian Institute of Science. He was called for two interviews in Delhi. He wanted very much to become a pilot. So he applied for getting this training. And another thing he applied was for the junior scientist post. He gave interview in both. For the pilot training, immediately they told him he cannot be a pilot. They were not satisfied with his physique. They were not satisfied with his looks. They said, no, we are not giving you chance. He was very, very disappointed because he very much wanted to become pilot. And then there was time to know about the results of another junior scientist post. So he thought he can take occasion and go to Rishikesh. He went to Rishikesh and he saw this Shivananda Maharaj of Divine Society. He was giving satsang to a lot of people. He went and stood in a corner. Shivananda Maharaj called him to the front. Come, what's your name, boy? Then he told his name. And he was expecting, I'm a Muslim boy, no? So there will be definitely a change in the face. But there was no change in the face of Shivanandi Maharaj. With same smiling face, he said, you are having something in your mind. You are troubled, no? You are feeling a little bit depressed, is it not? Why? Then Kalam told him everything. Yes, I have given interviews. Then in one I have miserably failed. But I wanted very much to become pilot, you know. Then Shivananda Maharaj laughed and said, "You are not fit to become pilot. You are going to become a rocket pilot and you are going to become a satellite engineer. So you need not be distressed about not becoming a pilot." So you are something far, far more than becoming pilot. Then a smile came to Kalam's face. He told Kalam, "My dear boy, whatever if you want to achieve wholeheartedly as the divine spirit, how to do it also," he said, "before going to sleep or in the early morning, you practice this. You intensely pray. You pray to, if you don't believe God, you intensely pray to universe. Look at the sky and tell, 'I want to become this. Really, I want to become this wholeheartedly before sleep.' You will see that it will become 1,000 times strong in the morning and come back to you. God will give you that strength." I think definitely Kalam has practiced, otherwise he has gone to the top of the country, you know. The boy who was called Akbar was not taken to become a pilot. Finally, he ended up as the president of India, is it not? That you know. So if it can hold for Kalam, of course Kalam, we say, oh, he is a scientist, was extraordinarily intelligent. But he came from a very poor and common circumstances like us. He struggled like us. That we must remember. So this is one of the laws they call law of attraction. The subconscious mind, even the unconscious mind, is very powerful. It connects with all the minds and the universal mind. So it connects with the entire universe. If I really ask something from that universal spirit wholeheartedly, I will definitely get it. So only thing is, they say there is no past, present or future in this. So don't say, "Oh, I want to become, oh, I want to become, I still think I'm an ugly duckling and I want to become that." That's what we are asking. No, imagine yourself, you are a swan and you are really swan. That is what he says. They say you are in the present. In this subconscious mind or with the unconscious mind, all the past, future, present becomes one. So what you believe, that you become. So devote a few minutes for tending this subconscious just before falling asleep. This is one of the great techniques. Don't fall into sleep. Don't slide into sleep with all types of hijibiji, all sorts of nasty thoughts. Go with some really powerful thought and it will really help you. See, a story from Edgar Casey I'm telling now. I think time is over, I think. 10 minutes. See, Edgar Casey was actually a journalist and turned into a psychologist and turned into a superman with this past regression theory and whatnot. He was able to predict or tell the people their past lives, the coming days and everything. He was actually mastered this. He mastered this by, he himself has acknowledged, from some ancient rishis because of his own past readings, past life readings. Anyway, he tells about some of the stories which are very, very educational for us. He says one of the parents came with a boy, small boy of 10 years old. He was all night, he was mild and he was soft and everything. But though he was 10 years, he was always afraid in the dark. And he was very afraid to be with alone. And night time he used to bedwet. Parents were very serious. What happened to this boy? Why he has become like this? It is not that he is not intelligent. But he is always so shy and so depressed, he can't do anything in the life. Then he did a past reading, past life reading, and he told the parents, see, this boy was an extraordinarily brilliant, sharp intellect in his last life. He was a literary critic. He used to criticize everybody. His sharp tongue was so sharp that the people will feel depressed and feel they will lose their self-confidence if they stand in front of him. His tongue was so sharp. So now it has come back to him as his karmapala, and he himself has become such a coward, afraid of everything, everybody, and very shy. Then mother asked, what is the remedy? What can I do for my boy? Then Edgar Casey told her, see, just before night, when the boy is falling asleep, daily you put your nail some good thoughts into his mind. You tell him, he's a very brave boy, he's a very good boy, he will help everybody in the world, he loves everyone. Like this, he goes on telling this. Repeat these thoughts. Say 4 or 5 thoughts, you keep it in your mind. Daily repeat when your boy goes to sleep. So there was a remarkable change after a few days. The boy first started helping everybody in the classroom. Then the people automatically took him as a leader. He came out of his shyness and he came out of his shelf that he created for himself. The isolation ended and he became a very popular boy. This time intelligent as well as good boy. He was not at all criticizing anybody anymore. See, that is the effect of our criticizing somebody. You can imagine how far this karma phala goes. So whatever I give to this universe comes back to me in 10 times like that. That we have to remember. So if I hate anybody, I'm hating myself. If I love anybody, I'm loving myself. That is why Swamiji insisted, serve others, serve others. Your mind blocks will be opened up if you start serving others and loving others. If you think you are weak, Swamiji said, weak you will be. Whatever you think you will be, we are strong, omnipotent, omnipresent beings. See, this is what in Sanskrit we call dhriti. The mind turns into will or dhruti. If the will is combined into with the desire or the sankalpa, that's what Abdul Kalam did, is it not? He wanted to become a scientist in a good sense, not in competition or not in defeating others or anything. So his will now has changed into a very strong will. Though sankalpa was attached with that, I want to become this, I want to become that, is the sankalpa. So it has attached to that. It becomes like a strong current. Say, we all know in science that if you drive the electrons in one way, it becomes current. If the electrons go haphazardly, then it is not current. You can't get current. See, look at an iron piece. It is an iron piece after all. But take a magnet and make all the atoms and you make them in the stand in a line like a soldiers. So once they stand in soldiers, now we have got a magnet. So the power will be emanating as soon as we control our mind and it flows in one direction. So Swamiji says we can make it as a gigantic battery of will. This tremendous will can do anything and everything. If you want to become scientist, you can. If you want to become doctor, you can. If you want to become a social worker, you can. You can have a great personality as we have seen. So Swamiji used to say, Kim Rodishi Sakhe Tvai Sarva Shakti. That means all goodness is in you. Many of us have no idea how much goodness, strength, greatness crying within us for self-manifestation. We are just putting them aside and telling, oh, we are nothing, we are nothing, we are nothing. But allow them to manifest. Let them come out. Then you see you are changed perfectly. So this is a Sanskrit shloka. Those who know Sanskrit, they can understand. Kim Rodishi, why are you crying? Sakhe, my dear friend. Tvai sarva shakti, within you is all energy, unbounded energy. So this is Swamiji's blessings on all of you. Be great in your thought, be great in your words, be great in your deeds. And develop a tremendous will and overcome all the mental blocks. So with this, with the Swamiji's blessings on all of you showing, so I hope you will again struggle, and once you realize you have got a lot of potential inside, you will start manifesting it. Okay? That is his blessing. Or shall we have it at the end of the day? What shall we do? If anybody has got any question, you come on.
Ahit Prashna? Haan. बरं बाकीच्या तोपर्यंत त्यांचं स्लाईड नाही येईपर्यंत सगळ्यांनी म्हणजे थोडं अंतर्मुख झालात का तुम्ही? हां, मनामध्ये विचार यायला लागले आणि सगळ्यांना मराठी मतलब अगदी प्रसिद्ध गीत आपण लहानपणापासून ऐकतो हो ना, सुरुवातीची जी गोष्ट होती माताजींनी सांगितलं कुठलं आहे ते, एका तळ्यात होती बदके पिले सुरेख, हो की नाही, तीच गोष्ट आहे कवितेच्या रूपामध्ये आपल्याला आपल्यासमोर खूप छान गाणं आपल्याला माहिती आहे सगळ्यांना, आणि आपल्या सगळ्यांमध्येच तसे मनामध्ये खूप विचार असतात, मला हे येत नाही, मला ते येत नाही, हो की नाही, तर त्याच्यातनं कसं बाहेर पडायचं आणि आपण हे बघूया. आणि त्यातले मला कोणीतरी दोन तीन मुद्दे सांगायचे आहेत महत्त्वाचे त्याच्यामधले, तुम्हाला काय आवडले ते.
This is the end of the slide. This one you wanted to ask? Huh? Oh, you can be individual. That is the last one. See, once you remove your mental blocks, the hurdles, the infinite energy is manifesting through us. It is not that, see, Swamiji, who is Swamiji? He is also a conductor of the divine spirit or divine energy. He has removed his blocks, he has become a good conductor, and he has manifested. Now, what is happening to us? We are bad conductors. We have got many blocks, which is blocking the universal energy to flow through us. This alone is manifesting in all possible, in one, if you are having electricity. Here it is manifesting as light, there it is manifesting as the pictures, there it is another place it is manifesting as heater. So the same light, same energy is manifesting in a various ways. And when uncontrolled, it can be like a lightning or thunder, it can even destroy. So this universal energy is manifesting through us. It is crying to manifest, but we are not allowing. That is what Swamiji is telling. So there are many, many examples who have manifested that energy. So Swamiji is only one of the examples. So those who have manifested, Abdul Kalam manifested in his own way. So every great person has manifested it in his own way. All of them had one thing common, that is out-of-box thinking. They didn't want to be a common place person. They wanted to come out of these prejudices. They wanted to have open-mindedness. So that is why they could become great. If Kalam was just like any other orthodox person, he could never have become so great like this. So that is the thing. So that mental blocks, if we remove, then energy will flow by itself. Because we are all conductors, whether good or bad. This is so.
Huh.
What can answer? I feel hot inside. You should not give that answer. So I get disturbed for that. So what is the solution for that? Without that, how do you
Could you hear answer which is against my own this thing, mine? What I really feel true, I cannot express. In that case, it is instead of saying something lie or just delicious to others, it is better to be quiet, keep quiet, and detach from there these small infightings. That's all.
तर माताजी म्हणजे जसं स्लाईडमध्ये आपण पाहिलं मॅनिफेस्टेशन म्हणजे काय प्रगटीकरण हां आपल्या सगळ्यांमध्ये अशा अनेक शक्ती आहेत ज्यांना प्रकट होण्याची सुप्त इच्छा आहे पण आपण त्यांना परवानगी देत नाही कारण का आपल्यामध्ये खूप सारे ब्लॉक्स आहेत ते ब्लॉक काढले की काय होणार आहे ते सगळी जी तो शक्तीचा जो स्त्रोत आहे ना तो सदैव वाहता होणार आहे आणि आपण देखील तसेच कोणीतरी होऊ असं सगळ्या स्लाईडचं म्हणजे सगळ्यांमध्ये ते गुण आहेत आणि आपण त्याच्यात एक होतं स्वामीजींचं वाक्य ना की आपण सगळे त्या असीम शक्तीस्त्रोताचा जो समुद्र आहे ना त्याचाच एक एक बिंदू आहोत कळतंय मग आपल्या पाठीमागे सगळ्या सगळ्यांच्या काय आहे तो असीम समुद्र आहे तो सागर आहे त्याच्यामुळे आपण तेच आहोत वी ऑल आर कनेक्टेड माताजी म्हणाल्या तर ते कनेक्शन विसरलं की आपल्याला वाटतं अरे आम्ही काहीच नाही आहोत असं आहे आपण आता दिवसभर त्याच्या अनुषंगाने चर्चा करणार आहोत तेच विषय ऐकणार आहोत तर आणखी कोणी आहे का नाही तर तुम्ही प्रश्न काढून ठेवा तुम्हाला जे वाटतील ते आणि हां
See, conscious mind is what we know. What I am thinking this way, I am doing that way, or I know that person, I know this person, then I am consciously thinking I know this. Even sometimes when I get angry, first I don't understand, that time the anger is in my subconscious. But once it gets to the upper level, I get angry. That time it has come to conscious level. Somebody is saying something, first I will not react. That time it may be that thoughts are all sinking to subconscious. I am keeping quiet. But after a few minutes I am seeing that my anger is rising. I even note, oh yes, my anger is rising. But once it envelops the entire mind, I become angry. I become that thought. That is conscious level. So, conscious level, what is happening, we know. But subconscious level, what is happening, we don't know. That is why when we sometimes in the dreams and all, we see some disastrous thing happening. That is from where it is coming. It is coming from subconscious. In the awakened state, I will say, ah, I never thought that way. Why did I feel like that? As if I am falling from a great height or fire is everywhere and all sorts of things I am seeing in the dream. What is that actually? A fear has subsided into your subconscious. Maybe you have got exams ahead. There is a fear. Maybe I will not be able to do. But it is not so, you are not so aware of the fear. But subconscious becomes aware of that fear and shows you dreams. Dreams is you may see, oh, I am going to write but my hand is not writing. I did not finish at all and the bell has gone and they are taking away my papers. So these are the fears that are expressing in your dreams. You may not have thought about it in detail at all. Sometimes even in a symbolic way it will appear. Very symbolic way. So this, everything is cooked up by subconscious. That is okay so long as we are able to control the conscious mind. But once these bubbles from subconscious mind come so rushing, then my conscious mind cannot control it. Then we say pagal. This person has turned into a mental patient. He can't control, he can go on talking and talking, he doesn't know what he is talking, what he is doing. He is now under the control of his subconscious mind. That is why. That is the reason. So I showed you this iceberg picture, na? That is one of the good pictures that we can understand very nicely. Everybody can understand. This one. This picture. See, in the uppermost conscious level, I feel good. Okay, I'm happy. But deep inside, I'm having anxiety, I'm having rejection, I'm having fear, I'm not fit for anything, even the guilt feeling. That is why Krishna said, you have to lift yourself and you have to be friend for yourself and you are your own enemy. That is the meaning. If I don't control this inside and clear these blocks, I will turn into my own enemy. That's the thing. Ipur Atmanaha, Bandur Atma, Manastasya, In Atma, Atmanatita. The thing will sink into your subconscious. Your thought will sink into subconscious. That's you are telling. But if I'm loud and if I hurt others or if I shout or do something, it will give a greater scar. Maybe it will stop if I don't react. But if I react, unnecessarily I will be dragged into a whirlpool of thoughts. There will be clash and I will have even a deeper wound. This wound, maybe I'm able to handle.